Hello everyone, this is Shelly and in today's video I will be sharing various reasons behind the large pores and also I will be sharing various solutions and products on how to shrink them. But before that, I want you to understand that pores are always present in our skin and they have been there in our skin from the time we are born. It's just that due to the aging process and various other factors, they look very prominent sometimes and sometimes they don't seem to exist. And again, since this is a vast topic and I don't want to rush upon the thing, so I have divided this topic into two parts. In today's video, I will be sharing two very common reasons behind the large pores, and further details I will share in the part two. So the reason number one for your large pores is the skin dehydration, and all skin types out there can get affected by this, including the oily skin. When our skin is dehydrated, the good water oil ratio gets disrupted, which result in drop of the water level and shoots up the excessive oil production, and the result is greasy, sticky skin on the surface with the large pores, and at the same time you will also experience dryness and stretchiness from the inside. So if you are somebody who is going through this skin dehydration and at the same time you're seeing those large pores on your skin, stop using all those astringents and toners with high alcohol content, or toners that says sebum reduction, oil control, etc. Like, stop using these kind of toners and instead focus on using a hydrating toners. And when you use these hydrating toner for a month or two, you will definitely see in shrinking of your pores and overall your skin will become more healthy. So if you have normal dry or very dry skin with the dehydration issue, you can check out the Rovectin Skin Essential Activating Treatment Lotion or the Hajalabo Premium Lotion. And both of these toners are extremely hydrating in nature and they are like mostly similar in terms of performance and how they feel on skin. But whenever I mention these two products, I often get asked like, is there any difference, and if so, then which is a better product? The subtle differences are like the Rovectin one is comparatively less viscous, whereas the Hajalabo one is more viscous, and the Rovectin one has 7 different types of hyaluronic acid, whereas the Hajalabo one has 5 different kinds of hyaluronic acid. And the most notable thing is that Rovectin one is 100% paraben free, whereas the Hajalabo one does contain paraben. Just because the Rovectin one has a clean ingredient list and superior ingredients, only because of this reason I prefer the Rovectin one over the Hajalabo one. Otherwise, I love both the toner equally. They perform very similarly on my skin and you can pick whatever you want unless you are concerned about the clean ingredient list thing. And if you have oily or combination skin, you can check out the Cosrx Propolis Synergy Toner or the Innisfree Green Tea Balancing Skin. And both of these toners are extremely hydrating in nature but are lightweight and doesn't feel sticky on skin. Toners that I have mentioned here are 100% oil free, they are 100% essential oil free, and they are all 100% fragrance free except for the Innisfree one. The Innisfree one does have some subtle added fragrance, so unless you are somebody who is like allergic to the added fragrance, you can skip on this one. Otherwise, this is really gentle and hydrating in nature. And the second reason behind large pores is the excessive oil in your skin or the congestion in your skin. And most of the time, oily skin and combination skin during the summertime gets affected by this. What I'm trying to say is like, if you see a normal skin which is healthy, you will see that the skin will have both oil and water level in a good ratio. But if your skin is dehydrated, you need to focus on bringing up the water level in your skin. But when your skin is greasy inside out, you need to focus on reducing that excessive oil in your skin without causing any disruption to the water level in your skin. So there are four things you can follow in your skincare routine to reduce that excessive oil production. If you are a beginner or you need something to use on a daily basis, you can check out the Cosrx original clear pad, and you can start with maybe 2-3 times per week, and then slowly you can start using it on a daily basis. And the other thing you can check out is the Cosrx BHA blackhead power liquid, and this contains 4% of betaine salicylate, so this is why it is not supposed to be used on a daily basis. You can start with maybe one time per week, and then slowly you can build it up to 3 times per week frequency, but do not use it daily. It will cause damage on your skin. If you are somebody who is not comfortable with the BHA based product, you can check out the clay mask. And the product which I specifically want to mention under this category is the Innisfree Super Volcanic Pore Clay Mask 2X. And this product is very effective mainly because it will help in cleaning out the dirt from your pore. It will help in reducing the excessive sebum in your skin. And finally, and very importantly, it helps in shrinking your pores due to the cooling effects which it provides on your skin. And use it only 1 or 2 times per week. Do not use it more often, otherwise it can dry out your skin. And if I compare this with the Innisfree Mousse Mask which I am using currently, this pot version is more effective in shrinking the pore. The mousse version is more like an exfoliating product. The other thing you can add to your routine is the niacinamide based product. The ingredient niacinamide is very helpful to our skin. It helps in calming the skin, it reduces the excessive oil production, it brightens the skin, and especially in oily skin, it is very useful in improving the barrier. So all of these factors work together and will eventually help in reducing the pore size. So if you have oily or combination skin, you can check out the Ordinary Niacinamide 10% with Zinc 1%. But if you have dry or sensitive skin, introduce this product very carefully, like start with maybe 2-3 times in a week, and then you can slowly start using it daily. And I'm saying this out of my experience. Like for my dry, sensitive and acne prone skin, this product broke me out really badly, and so I passed it on to my mom who has oily and acne prone skin, and on her skin this product worked quite well. Like, she did see an overall skin improvement. So I just wanted to mention this thing over here, and I guess I will have to look out for other niacinamide product. So the fourth thing which you can do to shrink your pore is start using an oil cleanser in your nighttime skincare routine. And you use the oil cleanser at night on your dry face with your dry hand and massage for 30-40 seconds. Let the oil melt down your makeup or sunscreen or dirt on your face, and add a little water so that the oily solution turns into a milky solution, and this is the emulsification. And again massage for 30-40 seconds and then rinse it off with a plain water, and do follow up with a foaming cleanser. Oil cleanser not only helps in getting rid of the makeup, the sunscreen, the dirt, the oil on your skin surface, but it will also help in getting rid of the trapped excessive oil and dirt in your pores. So eventually, over the time, it will help in shrinking your pores. And one product which I specifically want to mention here is the Troy Arocare XN Oil Cut Cleansing. And it is because this is a very unique product. Like, this is a first step cleanser. You use it exactly like any other oil cleanser out there in the market, but this doesn't have any kind of oil in it. And there are two ways you can use this. Like on days you have the full face makeup on, use your lip and eye remover first to get rid of the waterproof point makeup, and then use this on your face to get rid of the base makeup, and then you need to follow up with your foaming cleanser. And on the days you are not wearing any makeup, like you have only used your BB cream or sunscreen, you can use it alone, and like you can use it on your dry face, massage for 30 seconds, add a little water and again massage for 30-40 seconds and rinse it off. And that's all. You don't have to use any kind of foaming cleanser. It's totally optional. And the other thing which makes this product special is that when compared to all the oil cleanser that I have ever used, this has helped a lot in reducing the pore size. Like whenever I use this consistently for a month time, I see that my pores are like reduced. They are not that obvious on my face. So lastly, I want to say that whenever you see that your face is filled with excessive oil and your pores are looking large, don't simply make a conclusion that you need to use a product to dry down your skin. First, take a step back and understand why are you getting this excessive oil on your skin. Like, is it because of the dehydration or is it mainly because of the excessive oil? First, understand this and then only pick a product according to the condition. So that's all for this video, and I will see you again in the part 2 of this video. Bye.